Hello?
What is
it? Where's your mask? Where is your mask?
I'm in my car. What are you talking about?
Yeah, and you're not wearing a mask. Put your mask on.
I'm in my car. I don't need a mask in my car.
We all have to wear a mask. Put
continue on and on and on and on as a woman.
Oh, I like that way of thinking.
You mean you want to be on the show forever?
Yes.
So did Louis. Good luck.
What?
Because look how close you parked.
Okay, I'll move my car.
No, you're not moving your car. We're staying right here till the cops come.
No, I'm gonna move my car.
No, you're staying right here. Stop filming me.
Hey.
Yes.
Hey.
Okay, what?
I'll call you back. Hey, I have seen you around this neighborhood too many times. This is ridiculous. Your car is insanely loud. No. No. There are children that live in this neighborhood. You need to drive somewhere. You know what? I'm calling the police. This is insane. Don't you even think about going anywhere. I'm calling right now. This is insane. You cannot just be driving this loud car in this neighborhood at all hours. I'm calling right now. Don't you even think about going anywhere. This is ridiculous.
Reporting me now? Hey, internet. This man and his Doberman just attacked me and my Chihuahua.
It's not a Doberman.
What
are you doing?
I'm not putting you down.
Put me down.
I won't.
Some people go put me down.
Eh?
Put me down.
Some
people go. Hey, put me down, people. Put me down. I will strangle you. Put me down.
You will strangle
put
me.
No, place this one. Put me down, people. Hey. I'm warning you. Mama, go on. Want to know you fall on your feet? Put me down.
You slap
put
me, I said.
Put me down. Put me down. I will slap you last warning. This is my last one. I will use that as an example for others.
Last warning.
I will use you as an example now. Put me down. Or I will deal with you now. Put me down, people. Put me down.
Calm down.
Jeez.
What the?
Go
Girl, you better sit up before you get us all in trouble.
I've been telling her that.
Before who get in trouble?
Before Dr. G comes in.
I don't get in trouble. I'm a grown-ass woman. If Dr. G come here and say something to me, she might want to have a little word, a conversation, but I won't be in trouble. I'm a grown-ass woman. The only person I'll ever be in trouble with is my mama and God. And right now, neither one of them is disappointed in me. Thank you. Hello.
Ladies, come on.
There is no one in the store.
There's me in the store.
There's you. So you stand 7,000 feet away from me.
Ma'am, I'm just trying to do my job.
Here, and I'm trying to make sure that I have rights. So you're going to hear that they're actually going. You'll make sure to hear that in the end, you're the one who will be cited, not me.
Okay, fine.
So, yep, I'll just stand right here because I'm here. I've driven 20 minutes out. I'll drive 20 minutes back just for my babies who are hungry.
911, what's your emergency?
Yeah, as the 1964 Civil Rights Act, I cannot be discriminated against. I do have a right to be able to breathe O2, not CO2, and I am being discriminated against right now at a store. So,
are you calling to report something now?
Yes, that I am not being allowed into the store because I'm being discriminated against.
Because you would not like to wear a mask?
Being discriminated against. In what store are you at?
And I'm being discriminated against because I'm being told I need to wear a mask, even though I have a religious exemption right and a God-given right to be able to breathe O2.
I thought it was
CO2.
A medical exemption.
Uh-huh, yes, medical exemption too. It's all under the same topic.
What is that location address?
Let's see here.
They have two locations.
They actually have three. And they close in 6 minutes from now as well, and I'm just here to buy a couple of items. So I don't know if this is going to turn into a whole long thing when I'm just here for a couple of items.
If you need them so badly, why not just put on a mask? It's so easy.
I won't wear a mask.
Okay, that's your decision.
Okay, yes.
Okay, just try not to argue. I'm sorry. I'm going to
put a phone. There's also not one person in the store. They're about to close. You know, stores are actually accommodating people.
Do they have a sign posted that is saying that they're...
Right here.
So yeah, right now, you can have a sign. That still doesn't mean...
I mean, we're a private business with private rights.
Right, but it's also not a law. So I could actually... So you're one of the first people that I've called 911 who actually doesn't seem to understand that in the end, I'm actually the one with the rights. Even though it's mandated, it's not actually a law. It's based off of an emergency, state of emergency, that we are no longer in. So... That's okay. I mean, you can say all you want. I do know in the end I have the right, and in the end, okay, if I wanted to sue this gentleman, I could and I will win. I'll work with Del Bigtree. I'll work with Robert Kennedy Jr. I'll work with Peggy Hall, that you might not be familiar with, but I am, and I know that everyone who calls in order to have their rights be supported, to be able to shop by being able to breathe in O2, not CO2, they're all winning their cases.
Okay, ma'am.
I will wait in my truck. Here's the thing. What's going to happen is the gentleman is going to close his door because they close in 4 minutes. I drove all the way out here to purchase a couple of items. So what exactly should I do? Because I'd like to just walk on in, grab the items.
At this point, if he's not allowing you in, he is the owner of the store. They have the right to refuse service to anybody.
He's not the owner.
Illegal. Okay. Well, they still have a right to refuse service if he's an employee there. And I am going to send an officer out to you. They can talk to you once they arrive. I have no control over if they close the store in the meantime. I'm sorry about that.
Okay, so then you could just let the officer know that I'm leaving.
You don't want us to come out then?
I don't want you to come out because all I really want is for you to support me, for me to be able to purchase a few items.
Okay, but I don't have control over them not letting you in at this point from the phone. And I am not able to tell them they can't close. So
are you going live too?
I'm just recording.
You're recording me? That's fine. You are welcome to do your research to find it in the end.
Ma'am,
right.
I don't care.
No, that's fine, because I am here to be purchasing items. I'm not here to be speaking with an officer who knows that in the end, I'm the one who has the rights.
Ma'am, you hear them. You hear me. I'm just doing my job. Can you step outside?
Yeah, uh-huh. And could you make sure that this gentleman gives me his name as well, ma'am, just through the phone? Can you at least help me? So at least I have your name, because if I wanted to, I could take it further, and I won't.
Okay, fine.
I'm not here to do that.
Okay, have a lovely day.
But in the end, I was discriminated against for not being able to stop shop at your store.
That's your narrative.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you. In fact, I'll just go live too for a second.
I mean, if you want to.
Okay.
I'm just doing my job.
And I'm just
I have
my
rules.
Job.
I will get in trouble if I let you in without a mask. We have a lot of elderly customers. You know, it's a county.
Elderly customers
it
here.
Really doesn't matter.
Yeah, okay.
Such a wonderful human being.